4 hours away from Metro Manila is this very beautiful place that they call Las Casas Filipinas de Acuzar. So we're at the driveway and this is what I am seeing right now. Look at that. We're gonna go inside. Let us go.
It's hot.
It's hot.
Eat it. An
umbrella. So we're gonna pay your fee, so 2,500 for a day tour, and then we're gonna ride the jeep now going to Casa Lubao, which is the first cottage, the first house for the day tour. This is the first stop of the tour. This is called Casa Lubao. It's the one behind me. See that? It's a very, very nice building. We're gonna go around the entire Las Casas de Acuzar compound. This is a very, very big space. I think the Acuzar family acquired most of the houses here, and they basically bought the houses and then they transferred everything brick by brick, piece by piece, and then they reassembled everything in this place. It's a very, very good place to be in, to walk around if you want to see how really beautiful old Manila was. So a lot of the historical houses are here. I'm so excited. I'm like a kid, just marveled at the beauty of this place. So more to come later. We're now walking. We're done with the first house, which was Casa Lubao. Then they said we are going to watch a small reenactment of what happened to the house, or the second house that we're going. Place really nice. So that's Casa Lubao. I'm gonna go now here. This is where they're gonna do this small presentation. We're gonna watch it. Currently climbing, this is like the third house. So this is apparently is the house of the Luna brothers. So one is a wartime general, and then the other one is, if I remember correctly, one of our great artists, Antonio Luna. So this is inside. This is like their antique collection of Mr. Jerry Acuzar. Going through a narrow pathway. This is called the Volada. I'll try to explain what is a Volada later, so that I won't disrupt the tour. Inside Hotel de Oriente. This is like the second, or if not the best, hotel back in Manila before it got bombed after World War II. As you can see, this is so nice. This is so nice. We're gonna go upstairs, but as you can see, a lot of the interiors. Okay, I'll try to flip it later, so I'll make you guys see it. Everything you see here are wood carvings. Everything's made from wood. That's wood carving. So everything is hand carved on wood, even the ceilings. Look at the detail on that one. It's very, very well made. They said this was created by wood carvers from Paete. I think that's in Laguna, so. This is inside the lobby. This is the lobby. This is the ground floor of the Hotel de Oriente. very much a replica, is what everyone told us. Because the original structure was destroyed after World War II. Now the person behind the door at the entrance told us that, and this is also part of the walking tour, that Hotel de Oriente was the best hotel in Metro Manila, if not in the Philippines, because it had electricity, it had a phone line, and it housed so many important people. So Malacañang's area code is 1, Hotel de Oriente's area code is 2. So you just imagine, this was probably the most luxurious hotel ever during the Spanish era. So we're here at the second floor. I'm gonna stand behind one door, okay? Check this out! It's very nice. And the ceiling above me is this. I'm gonna flip the phone again and flip the camera so that you guys can see what I am seeing. This is the second floor. This replica of Hotel de Oriente is currently being used as a multi-purpose function hall. One of the more important functions or events that was held here was the APEC Summit. So, already walking. This is the Manila Hall, so we're gonna go inside. Just look at that. I think they can house around 150 to 200 people here. It's just amazing. Just amazing. Very, very nice.
Feel the air getting colder, and know something's missing here. I need your warm right here. I need you to light a fire. Can you reach me in time? Can
Las Casas in the evening. See, it's so nice. We're done with the day tour. I'm gonna head home. It's a very beautiful place. It's a very nice spot to be in. So if you have 4 or 5 hours to spare, go here to Bataan and check this place out.